I know most persons who have a computer uses the browser more often than any other application. And most of those persons use Google Chrome because it's the best, right? Well, if you think so, then I have 5 changes here that you need to make within Google Chrome just to make the browser better. Plus, I got some personal extension tips at the end. Now, I'm going to go ahead and launch my Google Chrome here. And the first thing that you're going to have to do is go into settings.
Say what now?
I'm just kidding. All that we're going to do is going to be within settings. The first setting that you need to adjust is within privacy and security. Here, where you see security check, go ahead and click on check now. It's going to run a check on all of your system, all of your passwords and your history and your extensions. And if you have any issues, you can go ahead and review them and remove any old passwords that you no longer use. In addition, you can come down here to where you have security and scroll way down to where you see advanced. And here where you see use secure DNS, you can select Cloudflare here from the list. It's a very good DNS security that I came across. Also, here where you have site settings, you can go ahead and block third-party cookies so that you don't get that annoying pop-up that asks you if you have to allow cookies. And here for pop-up and redirects, you can go ahead and select don't allow sites to send pop-ups. But some websites might need this depending on what you're doing. So if you're doing a specific task and it's not working out, then you can go ahead and come back here and just allow it for that time. The next section is going to be within search engine. Once you come here, your default search engine is Google Chrome. Now, I know this is probably what 95% of you use, but if you don't already know, Google is a very big company and they do track you and they do sell your data. So in order to prevent Google from actually taking your data, or at least some of it, you can go ahead and change your default search here to DuckDuckGo because this is a more secure search engine and they do not sell your data. Now keep in mind, the data selling that I'm actually talking about is basically ways that Google Chrome takes your information in order to push ads to you that they think you might be interested in. If you're not interested in those ads like myself, then you can try another browser like Firefox, but we're just going to be talking about Google Chrome here. For those who actually want to use it, they have their Google account integrated with it and they just want to get a better experience with it. The next section is going to be within system here. You'll click on that and you have an option here where basically the apps that require Google Chrome, they run in the background still. And that definitely can eat up some system resources and memory. So you can go ahead and turn that off to prevent Google Chrome from keeping those apps running in the background. The next section here is within downloads, and this is a small option that you might want to change, but you may not know that the option is here. So if you usually want your files to be in downloads, you can just have it automatically save them in downloads here. However, if you want Google Chrome to ask you where you want to save specific files, some persons might want this, some persons might not want this. They just might want everything to go into one place, which is the downloads folder. That's fine. But the option is here for those who want to specify the folder each file will be downloaded to. The final option that we have here is to reset your settings. And this would be like if you're having severe performance issues with Google Chrome and you feel like you just need to clean everything up and you want to start fresh, then you can go ahead and reset the settings from here. Now, my final tip here for all of you who are using Google Chrome is to download a few extensions, and I just have 5 of them here that I want to share with you. The first one will be Adblocker. And you can use either Adblocker Plus or you can use this other one that's just called Adblock. Both of them are good. I actually have both of them enabled. I'm not sure. I just want to make sure that I don't see ads.
Next.
Beliner is an extension that basically speeds up the entire browsing experience of your browser.
Next.
Dark Reader basically makes everything on the browser dark. All the pages that you would want to be in white, Dark Reader makes them dark and it's easier to read at night.
Next.
Return YouTube Dislike. You can actually see the videos that have a lot of dislikes on them. This will kind of give you an idea if the video is factual or not, or if the information that the person is saying in the video is substantial or not. If it has a lot of dislikes, then it might not be valuable information that the person is saying.
Next.
YouTube nonstop. So basically, when your YouTube video is playing and you're doing something around the house, or you're just doing whatever you're doing and you're not paying the computer any attention, but you just want your YouTube videos to play, whether it's music or whatever. After a while, the video will pause and it says, video pause, continue watching. So this extension basically removes that so that your YouTube videos will continue playing forever. So those are my few quick Google Chrome optimizations. The last thing that you can actually do is get a theme just to personalize the look of your browser, but that's really up to you. You don't have to. I don't have any installed, so that's what it is. So thank you guys very much for watching. I hope this helped you in some way, and I'll see you in the next one.